Am I glad I made it here? I drove all the way from Alhambra.
Oh, wow.
Do you know where Alhambra is? East of East LA.
Yes.
It's west of West Covina. And it's south of South Pasadena. I can't believe it. Oh man, am I glad I'm here? Because I made it safely, you know. I'm an Asian American. My name is Peter Chen, that's C-H-E-N, and I'm not related to Jackie Chan, okay? Yeah. His last name is C-H-A-N, my last name is C-H-E-N, so we're not related. But being an American citizen for a long time, I'm glad that, you know, I've been so long a citizen. Now, the longer you become a citizen, the more you look like the people of the country. So I'm looking more and more like a Mexican. So cool, they call me El Culo. Mexican American are looking more and more like Asian American, and Asian American are looking more and more like Mexican American. That's why we're cooking each other's food. No, seriously, you ever look in the kitchen of a Chinese restaurant? You look at kitchen, everybody working in a Chinese restaurant is a Mexican or look like one. You go in the kitchen, you saw the cook, he's a Mexican guy. And he's stir-frying a wok, you know, oh la la, oh la la. I'm a Chino, I cannot get a job in a Chinese restaurant, you know this? And we all know why, I don't look Mexican enough. I got a job in a Mexican restaurant though, oh la la. In a Mexican restaurant as a cook, but I don't cook, because in a Mexican restaurant everything's already cooked. The bean, the rice, the chicken, everything cooked. Somewhere, somehow, someone is cooking them. Now me, see, I lose face, which is the opposite of safe face. Safe face is get respect, lose face is lose respect. I'm the Rodney Dangerfield of the Chinese guy, you know? Get no respect there, I lose face, okay? I lose face in a Mexican restaurant because I'm a cook and I don't cook. All I do is make burritos. Now burritos to me look like a giant egg roll, don't you think so? See, egg roll should not be called egg roll. There's no egg in it, it's not a roll. If you see egg and egg roll, I'm pretty sure it's a breakfast burrito, I'm pretty sure. You can't go wrong with that one. So speaking of getting jobs, you know, I never work in a swap meet. You guys work in a swap meet?
No, I
don't work anymore. Last time I worked in a swap meet, minding my own business, people like to pull me over, ask me questions. How much? How much? No, I don't work there, all right? It's not being Asian trying to look for a job. I try to get a job in a motel. I walk inside as an Asian, they thought I was gonna buy it. I got a job in a motel and they start bargaining with me and say, can you get a price? I say, I'm not the owner, okay? I just work here. Working in this motel, you have to wear this ugly looking vest. I say, hey man, do you have anything better looking than this? They say, better than bulletproof. Motel is this. My main job is to relocate picture frames according to the bullet holes. Hide the holes. This motel is not called Sunset Motel, it's called Sleazy Motel. It's on Sunset. Yeah, they don't have television. You want to watch murder, rape, violence? You look out the window. There's a little sticker on the window panel that means to increase volume, open window. It's a dark motel, man. They have only one little lamp in every room. I call it the one night stand. Thanks for getting that. I didn't lose face this time. Oh man, I'm telling you, it's not that easy being Asian, guys. I'm still learning English. Everything's opposite here. Like good is bad, bad is good. Like he's bad means he's good. I went to a bar, I tried to get a drink, and the bartender said, boy, you look ugly. I said, thank you. I went to a restroom, there was a sign that says wet floor. I'm too embarrassed to do it. No way, Jose, I'm not wetting the floor. You know, from China, right? I'm from Hong Kong, yeah. Here people say, what's up, what's up? In China, they say, what's down there? Any food left? Here people say, get down. Over in China, they say, get up and work. Here people say, space out. In China, they say, space in, and it's space in there for 10 people. It's crowded right there. Here people get Shanghai. In China, they get Detroited. Thanks for getting that. One time I got confused, a girl come over and says, I've got two things on my chest, I want to bounce them off you. Yes, please, both of them. Yeah, I can see that, you can tell that I'm single because I could not get a date, okay? See, Mexican guys, they get dates all the time. I could not get a date. Every time I asked a girl out, she said no. Finally, a girl said yes. I said, are you sure? She thought about saying, maybe not. One time a girl, she wanted to see more of me. I showed it to her. She said, that's not more, that's less. Oh no, I finally got a date. And after the date, I took her home, I dropped her off. And I said, can I have a kiss goodbye? She said, you Chinese, you don't kiss, you bow. Okay. On the second date, I took her home, I asked for a little piece, she gave me a piece of her mind. I said, don't lose your mind, I'm losing face. Oh. On the third date, I took her home, I dropped her off half a block from her house. She says, why? I said, you don't go all the way, I don't go all the way. I tried to shave my head to look cool because, you know, Mexican guys are cool, they shave their head. I shaved my head last winter and I didn't feel any cooler. In fact, I feel downright cold. And how can I get lucky when I look like a monk? And it takes forever to grow it back, you know, don't do that. I thought I looked like a cholo, but no, I didn't. My hair, nothing works on my hair. I try mousse. Mousse doesn't work. I'm looking for elk. Thank you. So you guys take those self-improvement class. You ever take those self-improvement class where you look in the mirror and you say, I love myself, I love myself? I took the same class. The instructor says, because I'm Asian, I have to look in the mirror and say, I'm a good driver, I'm a good driver. Hey, I'm a good driver. I don't have accidents. I've been driving for 30 years. I never have a single accident. I have a lot of accidents happening behind me. I like to go to a one-way traffic and everybody just give me the finger. What the hell? Yeah, I'm not number one. I like to go in the opposite direction. You know, people give me the finger. But it's not easy, you know. I mean, I don't drink and drive. I go to party, I drink non-alcoholic beer. The problem is I drink so much non-alcoholic beer, I have to go out and fake drunk driving. While I was driving on the freeway, faking drunk driving, a patrol car drove by. I looked over, two faces were looking at me. I go, uh-oh, I'm gonna get a ticket. One cop said no, the other cop, he said, keep going. He's an Asian driver, that's the way they drive. The other cop, there's two cops, the other cop, he's a really bad cop. He pulls me over, he said, do you know you're speeding? I said, dude, I was just following the speeding sign. Oh, the sign says 101. Dude, that's not the speeding sign, that's a highway sign. I said, I'm glad you tell me before I get a 4-5. So they told me to see the judge. The judge told me, says, you look familiar. Have you ever been up before me? I said, I don't know, judge. What time do you get up? He said, I want to know how much you know about traffic laws. Two cars come to the intersection at the same time. Who has the right of way? I said, that's very easy. The most expensive car. He said, what happened if both cars are Mercedes? Then I said, that's easier. The most beautiful driver. Ladies first. I hate driving because on the freeway, I have to cut somebody off. I'm sorry, that's my job. And every time I cut people off, I have to look in the rearview mirror. And every time I look, the driver behind and all the passengers, everybody's shaking their heads. I know what they're thinking. They're thinking, another Asian driver. I get especially PO when another Asian driver cutting me off. Then I get really mad and catch him up just looking. He has the nerve to look surprised. Yeah. To stop to let me go first. And every child on the bus simultaneously shaking their heads. I lose face. You guys like Chinese food?
Yeah.
Good crowd. I went to this Chinese restaurant. It's called Yu Fu. I figured something was wrong. They serve Mexican food. I came out looking at a sign change to fool you. This restaurant is $4.99 for all you can eat. I paid my $4.99 and the waiter brought me one egg roll and one bean sprout. I said, waiter, what's this? He said, that's all you can eat. This Chinese restaurant, they serve warm beer. And a beer imported all the way from the Yellow River of China. It's warm, it's bubbly, it's yellow. It's called Long Leek. Speaking of names like this, the Chinese names are pretty funny, okay? I can laugh because I'm Chinese. One guy is called Mr. Low. He has a milk factory in China. His name, Low Fat. He's a minister of China, church bell. His name, Ding Dong. Mr. How, he doesn't have a job in China. His name, How Come. Mr. Ong, he's a director of Chinese Gong Show. They canceled the show. His name, Ong Too Long. Well, you guys are fun. I don't know. What time? How much time do I have? Oh, man, I'm telling you. Okay, so my uncle, okay? My uncle, he doesn't like to get old. He's, I think he's 58 now. He doesn't like to go old, so he took this youth pill. And you can look younger and you do young things. He took the youth pill for 6 months. For 6 months, he took the youth pill. He did not look any younger, but he moved back into his parents' house. He got flunked out of adult school. He wrecked his dad's car and got a teenager pregnant. Can you believe the guy? I lose face for him. My uncle, he has a raggedy old car. His car cannot go over 25 miles an hour. I said, what happened if it goes over 25? He said, at 35, my windows start to shake. At 45, my seat starts to rattle. At 55, my engine starts to nod. I said, what happened at 65? He said, at 65, my car wants to apply for Social Security. It's not easy being Asian, I tell you, man. So, but anyway, my eyes, see, my eyes, I have big eyes, except that you guys see that I have small eyes because my eyelids cover too much of my eye. So I circumcise them. Now I'm part Chinese, I'm part Jewish, okay? Now I can do my accounting and I can drive. It's not easy being Asian, I tell you, man. I lose weight all the time. Let me see now. I'm trying to skip the subject because, you see, you guys have food fight here. You can food, okay? I can pick them up later. Hey, a can of sardine, you know? And speaking of fight, there's no Asian football player. You ever notice that? No Asian football player. Why? Because Asian people are smaller and shorter. Like me, I have a small, tiny neck. I cannot wear helmet. If I wear helmet, I look like a golf ball and a tee. And none of the Asians wear helmet because they cannot wear helmet, they look like a golf ball and a tee. And they all look alike. They say, where's the quarterback? There's no quarterback. Because they all look alike. And the quarterback is called one wing back. Speaking of this, my time is up. I want to tell you my Chinese nickname. You guys want to know?
Yeah.
All right, great crowd. My Chinese nickname is Ding Ho. Chinese American call me Gong Ho. Mexican American call me Bendejo. On the freeway, they call me UA Ho. In West Hollywood, they just call me Ho. Thank you very much, my name is Peter Chen.